Okay, here's a quick story. Recently, Ken and I were vacationing at a cabin on a lake, and one afternoon I was out on the lawn praying. It was a really personal prayer, and I said to Jesus, "Oh my goodness, Jesus, at my age, I am like the Apostle Paul. I am so torn. I want to be with you, to depart and be with you, Lord. Yet I know that if I remain, my labors will be fruitful." So I prayed, "Jesus, things are getting harder. So if I am to remain, I need an extra portion of you. I need extra faith. I need extra grace for the future, the days ahead." Just then the sprinklers went off, and the one right in front of me did not have a sprinkler head. And this forceful stream of water started pounding against my chest. I was dripping, wet all over, spitting and sputtering. Ken Tada was yelling at me from the porch, "Get out of there!" But when I went to move my wheelchair, the joystick fell off into the grass. I was stuck. And my very angry husband only got angrier when he had to come and get wet to rescue me. But at that point, with water still spraying, I start laughing. The whole thing was just so bizarre. And later inside the cabin, I marveled, but I laughed. And immediately, when I thought of that word laugh, one of my favorite verses hit me, Proverbs 31, verse 25. "She robes herself in strength and laughs at the days to come." Other translations say that she smiles at the future. And with that, it was God's way of assuring me that no matter how hard things get in the future, He's going to give me grace. And sometimes it might be grace enough to laugh.